There's a spirit that wants to silence you and prevent you from operating in the gifts that God has given you. Your mouth is your weapon against the kingdom of darkness, and the power of the tongue is life and death. The fervent, effective prayer of a righteous man avails much. It's through the mouth that the ministry gifts are used. Ephesians 4, verse 11. Jesus gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors, some teachers. These are administrative gifts, right? These are not titles. These are not things that you put in your Instagram bio or the title that you use to puff yourself up in front of men, but these are ministry gifts. Notice how they all require the mouth of one. In order to be an apostle, which is one who plants churches, you must be a leader. You must speak with your mouth. In order to be a prophet, you must prophesy with your mouth. To be an evangelist, you use your mouth as a tool to bring others into the kingdom of God. And of course, a pastor and a teacher, they use your mouth to do these things. So there's a spirit that wants to silence you. Of course, it's good to be silent. We are called to be quick to listen, slow to speak. When we are slow to speak, there is wisdom. Ecclesiastes 3 says that for everything there is a time and a season under heaven. There's a time to be silent and a time to speak. Yes, the time to be silent comes before the time to speak. But when you start flowing and operating in your ministry gift, there will be a spirit that wants to silence you. As long as your heart is pure, it's a continual heart check for us as Christians. As your heart is pure, as you truly want to do the will of the Lord, as you seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and you say, God, create in me a clean heart, and you know that your heart is right in the eyes of God because of the cleansing blood of Jesus, and because you are checking yourself daily, seeking to walk in repentance, then let it flow. Let the ministry gifts flow. Let the evangelizing flow. Let the teaching flow. Let the pastoring flow. Let the gifts that God has placed in you, let it flow as the Spirit leads. Don't be so rigid that you break, but know that there will be a spirit that want to silence you. This spirit can come from the mouth of family. This spirit can come from the mouth of pastors. It can come from leaders. It can come from those who love you most, right? It's not always them, but it's a spirit. Could be a spirit of conspiracy. There is a spirit from the enemy that will want to silence your mouth when God is using you for His glory. In the feeding of the 5,000, Jesus had compassion on the multitude. And what did He do? He didn't heal them. He didn't deliver them. He didn't feed them. But His initial response to His compassion was to teach them many things. For the whole day, I believe it was 3 days straight, Jesus is teaching them many things out of the compassion of His heart. So I'm giving you this word to let you know that when you are flowing and operating in the Holy Ghost, there is a spirit that wants to silence you. Maybe from pouring the wisdom into your kids, pouring the instruction, the knowledge into your children. Now, don't force feed them, because that's not godly, right? As the Spirit leads, continue to pour in the Word. Continue to plant the seeds depending on the season. Plant the seeds into the neighbor. Never force feed anyone. Don't cast your pearls onto swine unless they trample you. Okay? So don't allow people to trample you by throwing your pearls, your precious words of God, unto the wrong people. But know that when you are sowing seed into the minds of the young, into the minds of those who God wants you to steward, there will be a spirit that wants to silence you. Make sure you get your rest. Rest in the Lord. Get filled with the Spirit. Meditate in His Word. But in doing so, know that there will be a spirit coming against your mouth to shut you up and silence you when you operate and flow in your ministry gift. God bless you, my friend. I hope this word encouraged you, and I'll see you on the next episode. Bye-bye.